Hi, we are continuing with our Mishnah Yomim, Masechet Brachot. We are up to Perek Hey, Mishnah Aleph. The Mishnah now is going to discuss the different ways to prepare yourself for the prayer and how you're supposed to have focus and concentration and similar. The Mishnah writes like this. Just as an introduction, I want to read to you the Rambam in Elchot Tfilah, Perek Daled, and In the Perdaud, Halakha Aleph, Halakha Vav, Halakha Tetzayin, Hatfilah Tzicha Liyot B'Chavanat Alev. The prayer must be with the intent of the heart, the Hainu meaning, Shifne Ibon Mekol HaMachshavot V'Yireh Et Atzmo Kinu Omed Lefnei HaShchinah. You're supposed to remove all thoughts from your heart, and you're supposed to imagine yourself, envision yourself when you're standing before the divine presence of God. The Mishnah writes like this, En Omdin Nitpalel Ela Mitoch Kovod Rosh. The Rav writes like this, Hachna'a Mora. A person is supposed to pray Shemona Esrei. He's supposed to make his mindset before he prays humble and fear. Dichtiv, like the Pasuk writes, Idu at Hashem Bira. You must serve God with fear. Va'avodah zu tefilahi. When we say serve God, avodah, we mean prayer. You're supposed to pray with God, to God in awe, in trepidation, in humility. Mishnah continues, Chasidim HaRishonim, the Chassidim, the pious individuals of the previous time period, in the times of the Tanaim, they would wait an hour to prepare themselves in order to concentrate their heart to Hashem. Now the Mefarshim writes something very interesting. They would come to the place where they wanted to pray and they would wait an hour. They would focus on thoughts of Hashem. Now the Mefarshim writes something very interesting. It doesn't say that they focused on the words for an hour. It doesn't say kedei shechavnu et libam litfilatam, so they should focus in their prayer. It says they should focus kedei shechavnu et libam lamakom, to God. The Mefarshim write like this. From the fact that it chose the word lamakom, mevu'av, it comes out shehakavanata shehem na'agu kach kidei li'echad et machshavatam berumimut Hashem. They were trying to focus their thoughts in the honest, the highness of God. Besides for the fact that they obviously had kavanah for the intent of the words, what the words mean, they had an additional kavanah which was not required. That's why they were called chasidim. Halacha lemaaseh ikar adin, you don't have to wait an hour before, you have to wait a little bit so that you focus on what you're about to do. And you know, you look at the words, you know what the words mean, and you pray. But the Chassidim HaRishonim, Nifnim Mishurat Hadin, above the letter of the law, they waited an hour, and they focused on Romimut Hashem, the highness, the exaltedness of God. Va'afilu ha-melech shoel bishlamo lo yishivenu. And even if a king were to greet you, don't answer him. Now the Rav writes like this, Davka melech Yisrael. We're only talking about a Jewish king, that you, there's no fear that if you don't answer him, he'll kill you, because he realizes, oh wait, you're in the middle of praying. Aval melech obed kochavim, but a goy king who greets you in the middle of Shmona Esrei, posek shele algenu, you must stop even in the middle of Tfilat Shmona Esrei and answer him. Why? Pikuach nefesh, it's a danger, he might kill you. Therefore you stop and you answer him. The Mishnah ends off, ba'afilu nachash karuch al akivo, even if there's a snake wrapped around your ankle, your Achilles, lo yafsik. You do not stop. Now the Mefarshim write like this. Afilu nachash karuch al akevo, the Rav writes, davka nachash shevo pamim ino noshech. We're talking about a snake that doesn't bite majority of the times. Aval akrab, but a scorpion, or a rattlesnake, min advarim shevaday noshchim, species that certainly bite and is dangerous, umamitim, and they kill, posek. For that you stop. When the Mishnah says even a snake is around your ankle or Achilles, it's talking about it's not a danger, it's not going to harm you. But a rattlesnake, a scorpion, or a snake that's venomous, that'll kill you, of course you stop and you try to save your life. And the Mefarshim just write, to end off, Hafsakash she'alea midaberet ha-Mishnah. When we kept saying, interrupting for the king, interrupting for the snake, he hafsakah bedibu, we're talking about even verbally interrupting. For example, you scream out help, somebody should help you remove the snake. But to move locations, that's not called an interruption in the middle of prayer. And therefore, even if it's not a danger, you're praying and you notice that it's maybe in your vicinity, Or if it's on you and if you walk, he'll fall off. You're allowed to do that in the middle of tefillah. Some say, yesh sobrim, that even walking is hefsek, therefore there's no sakana, you're not allowed to move. And they learned the Mishnah a little bit differently. They learned that by a king you're not allowed to stop, by Melech sudden speaking, but by the snake it's not even allowed to move. If it's not dangerous, it's a different understanding of the Mishnah. Look at the Mefarshim over there. That is the end of Mishnah Aleph Rabotai. Mishnah Bet now discusses three additions we have in Shmon Esrei. We have the praise of God when we say Mashiv Ruach with the Geshem. We have the request in Barech Aleinu V'Teitanu Matar Libracha. We have Chonen Adad, we add in Atachonen Damdad, Havdalah, Tachon Antanu. The Mishnah is going to discuss now these additions. Mishnah says, Mazkirin Givurot Geshemim B'Tchiyat Hametim. We mention the strength of God that He provides rain in the blessing of the revival of the dead. When we say, before we say, Baruch Atah Hashem Mechayeh Metim, we say, Atah Gibor Le'olam Hashem, Mechayeh Metim Atah, Rab Le'oshia, Meshiva Ruach Mu'in Degeshem. We mention God's strength, the fact that He can revive the dead, and that He brings rain and moves the wind. The Rav writes, Meshiva Ruach, She'enu Lashon Bakasha, Lashon Askerat B'Shevach. When we say Meshiva Ruach, God blows the rain, He moves the rain, we're not requesting, we're saying a praise, God does this. We're not saying please do, we're saying God does. We're praising Him. ובפני שהגשמים אחד מגבורות של הקדוש ברוך הוא, תכתיב, עושה גבורות, עד ואין חוק חקר. From the fact that bringing rain is one of God's strengths, הנותן מטר על פני הארץ, where the pasuk says, עושה גדולות, עד אין חקר, נותן מטר על פני הארץ, משום הכי, therefore, קרא אלוהו גבורות גשמים. That's why we call rain strength. That's why we put in the blessing of strength. The pasuk refers to God's strength as bringing rain. The Mishnah continues, ושואלים הגשמים בברכת השנים. When we say ותנתנו מטר וחב, when we request rain, we put it in the blessing of ברך עלינו. Now the Rav said this שאלה, ותנתנו ומטר לשון בקשה. When we say ותנתנו מטר, we say please God give rain and dew, that's a request. We put that in the ברכת השנים. The Rav writes, why ברכת השנים? Why ברך עלינו? מתוך של פרנסה, since rain brings sustenance, קבו שאלתם בברכת פרנסה. We put the blessing of the request of rain and the blessing of sustenance in Barech Aleinu, when we pray for Parnasa. And the Mishnah writes, Vabdalah bechonen adat, Habdalah, when we say Tachon Antanu, we put that in Chonen Adat. And the Rav writes, Habdalah Motze Shabbat, obviously on Saturday night when we say Habdalah in Arvit, we put that in Chonen Adat. The Rav writes, Shi Bacha Rishona Shel Chol, because it's the first blessing that we say on a weekday. During Shabbat, we don't say Tachonen Adam Dad. We go into the Kela Kadosh, and then we start Yismachet Moshe, or we start the different ways of Shabbat prayers. But the first blessing of the weekday is Atachonen. Therefore, right there, we put the Havdalah. Ubi Yerushalmi Amu, but the Yerushalmi gives a deeper understanding. Why did Chachamim establish Havdalah, the separation of Shabbat and the weekday, in the blessing of granting knowledge? Because if a person has no wisdom, how can he distinguish between Shabbat and weekday? Therefore, we specifically put in the blessing of wisdom, that we should have the wisdom to understand the distinction. That's the halakha, that we put it in Chonen Adat. Rabbi Akiva argues, he says, Umrah bracha rivit b'pnei atzma. We say the blessing on its own. Meaning Rabbi Akiva says, after we say Hakel HaKadosh, we're going to say Atachon Antanu as its own blessing. That's what Rabbi Akiva says it. Because he says that Chonen Adat doesn't need to do Havdalah. Therefore, we're not going to put it inside, we're going to make it its own blessing. Therefore, you're going to end, you're going to say Atachon Antanu, Baruch Ad Hashem, Amadim Begol Shechol, according to Rabbi Akiva, and then Atachonen. But we don't hold like that in the halakha. The Mishnah ends up, Rabbi Eliezer Omer Behoda'a. Rabbi Eliezer goes even further. He says, when do you say Havdalah? Not in Atachonen Adam Dad, not in a blessing on its own as the fourth blessing, like Rabbi Akiva says. Rather, you say it in Hoda'ah, which the Mefarshim write like this. Rabbi Eliezer Sover, Rabbi Eliezer holds, Shehavdalah Kilula Gam Hoda'ah LaHashem. Havdalah has in it thanks of God, Hoda'ah, in the thanks. Al Shenatan Lanu De'ah LaAvdil Mekol Shechol. We're thanking God for the knowledge He gave us to distinguish between Shabbat and Chol. Or al shenatan lanu et Shabbat in Nucha, or we're thanking God for the fact that He gave us the rest day of Shabbat. Vavkin, therefore, yesh lo amrad ledaato bebirkat ha'odaa. According to him, we put it in the think sections of Shemona Esrei, the last three blessings. Ledaat Rabbi Eliezer, Havdalah ne'emer lifnei ha'milim ba'ad kulam. According to Rabbi Eliezer, the Meiri writes, you're going to say Havdalah before ba'ad kulam itbarach mitomam. B'makom shebo modim al shar ha'nisim, in the same spot where we usually say al ha'nisim. We finish modim anachnu lach. Right before Ba'al Kulam, when we add Ba'al Nisim, over there Rabbi Eliezer says you're going to add Atachu Nantanu and say Baruch Ata Hashem Amigdil Ben Kodesh Rechol. Again, Rabbutai, like we said, the halacha follows the first opinion that it's put inside of Chonen Adat. That is the end of today's Mishnah, Rabbutai. Everyone should have a Shabbat Shalom. Baruch Adonai Le'olam. Amen v'amen.